So, good morning. We're starting a mimer that we started yesterday. The name of the mimer is Tefila Lemoshe. And we're holding by Dalet. And the Ramachos is page Yudalef, Dalet. Even the back, the Indian shields of Pashto, so come over lay, my mind was sure she is like the leash. Oh, she is the lay like the talk of the Shumush Babu Shefa, Ribu a Shefa, well, Pizze. He looked been only gang she is the Machsero, the Oshu, Bishnion. He says, on a simple level, the concept of wealth, a wealthy man doesn't just have what he needs, he has abundance of what he needs. Let's say someone needs X amount of money to live every month, okay? So let's say you need $5,000 to live a month, and you're making $50,000. So it's way above and beyond what you need.
Right.
Or you're making $100,000. Right? So it says Lirak de Tzochov, it doesn't just have what he needs, a shumush pa beribu ya shefa, it's a tremendous amount of shefa that comes his way. Peace there, so the difference between a poor man. A poor man, even if he has what he needs, to a wealthy man, with two things. Even the things that the oni has, and the oshi has, what the poor man has and what the wealthy man has is two different things. For example, a poor man can have a car, and a wealthy man can have a car, but it's not going to be the same car, most likely. So well, even the things
in that book, they always drove the cheap cars, the millionaire next to the book.
Yeah, but actually, you think about it, if it's those that are making so much, it doesn't really make a difference anymore because they can write it off as a company expense.
The ones that are self-made are not going to fit. I can go get a Maserati.
Yeah. But the guy who gets a Maserati and pays, let's say, $1,000 a month on lease, that lease is tax deductible. Right. So he, instead of giving it to Uncle Sam, he just drove a nicer car. Why not?
Right. For me, I'd rather have the Sonata than that's all I would do.
Yeah, but I'm saying, if you were to make $50,000 a month, maybe you would think differently.
Maybe.
You know, don't know.
I don't know.
Maybe you give more tzedakah, but... So one thing, the poor and the rich has two things that are different, that they are different than each other. Not only with what they have. If you have something, I don't have it, it's for sure there's a difference. You have it, I don't. But if we both have the same thing, if we both have something, you have food and I have food. Yeah. So what's the difference between the poor and the rich? They both have food. So he said, even in that aspect, there's a difference. Seemingly, he's not efficient in these things. He has it. It's not the same like the poor. A poor man, meaning for himself, he's always lacking something. He's in a state of deficiency. And the wealthy man, is not. The only mitzvah that's me, u'chosar gam dvorim ele. Actually, before yesh nom lei dvorim, in actuality, he has it. Right now, he has these things. But only someone that from his mos, his essence, he needs. He needs someone else. He needs the help of other people.
It's a lack of emunah if you have what they eat today and you worry about tomorrow.
Right. So that's one in one aspect. Oh. The poor man would have what to eat, and the wealthy man has what to eat. But even in that, not that it's different, or he has better, like I thought, that the one guy has better than the other. One guy has better food, there's better transportation, there's better housing. That's not what he's saying. He's saying that the poor man for himself, he feels deficient, even when he has something.
It's the mentality, isn't it?
He's poor. That's what
he
said before, that the rich and poor is really bedas.
Right.
Is in your mind.
Right.
The only we said that's me chosel gam dvorim ela. Should be far yeshnam dvorim ela. He's deficient. In actuality, he has it, but mitzad atzim by himself, he feels that he's lacking it. Uve is the second difference between the rich and the poor. That he has abundance of whatever it is. By him, it's through the abundance. It says in Ruchnis, up till now he spoke on a physical level. On a spiritual level, you also have these two differences. Shnei Yonim. So, according to this, Oshir is someone that has something in his very essence. That's the one difference between rich and poor. And the second is that the poor has a chef, has a abundance, and the rich has abundance, the poor does not have it, right? Kluim ze bezesh vichdei shanim shumuchach boim yivetzos lebefesh mekabelosim shachem tzad atzmei. So they're both, these two inyanim are connected to one another. In order for him to have day machsere, to have everything that he needs, and not in a way that he receives them from other people, like the poor man. It's only through tremendous amount of abundance and flow that comes from above. So ribuy ha-shefa, the fact that there is abundance, it causes that what he has, he feels like it's mitzad atzmi, that he's a rich man. Ve'yin ba'avedo, what does it have to do with avedas Hashem, serving Hashem? Shavedas ha'adam rak if yaseget ha-seichel shaloi. If you're serving Hashem only up to your intellectual capacity, it stops right there. Whatever you understand, you do. Avedas Hashem is dependent on your intellect. Beside the fact that your Avedas Hashem is limited, serving Hashem in a limited way, they machsor, do exactly what you have to do.
You're talking about the poor person or the rich person or both of them.
We're talking about the poor person in spirituality.
Ah, okay.
So spiritually poor person, First of all, he serves Hashem to the... Is serving his Aveda Sa'adam, is serving Hashem, is limited to his understanding, number one. So he says, on top of it, that his serving Hashem is deficient, Sha'avedim did of Agbolo, Uchoser Gam, Vepnimus Gam Aveda Zo. Even what he does, even with what you said, he's serving Hashem up to his to the limit of his understanding.
Yeah.
But even that serving Hashem, it's deficient. Something is lacking within his avodas Hashem. Why? Pnimius gam avodas. So that's what I mean. Choser v'pnimius gam avodasu. Kevin shemitzad asogo yesh nesinas mokam laefech. Because you serving Hashem is limited to your understanding. Your understanding can also understand the opposite, which means you shouldn't do it. If you want to serve Hashem in such a way that there is no room, there's no possibility for the opposite, meaning for things that are contrary to serving Hashem. We ask to serve Hashem in a state of Ashirus, with no limitation. Meaning it's not limited in any way to your understanding.
Reb Zusha.
Ashirus. And that's a true Ashir.
Reb Zusha, you know the story about the press guy that went there and he says, what do you mean? I got everything. What are you talking about?
Right. כדי לבוא עניין השיעור של המילה ממילה החיסורן, in order to understand the concept of wealth that comes from above, fills any kind of deficiency. Think if someone has a lack in something and it's being filled, but overwhelmingly, it's not just filled. If someone says, oh, I need a dollar, he has a chisoron of a dollar, and the response is $10 million. So the chisoron is completely filled with, overwhelmingly filled, right? So he said, "V'chdel levor inyan ha'shiur shelemaylo milo chisoron." Makdi v'maymer, the Rebbe Rashab explained his maymer. Even when, in order to fill the deficiency, you have two levels. Seemingly it's redundant. The pasuk says, you have to give the wealth, you have to give, someone had money and lost it, or someone needs, says k'dei machsir asher, whatever he is lacking,
right.
The ashir, the wealthy, is lacking the, if he is in a state of, if he is right now broke, so the wealthy man, his machsir, his deficiency is much greater than the poor, because the wealthy man needs the horse, needs the guy to run in front of him, all these things that he got used to.
Yeah, they all get upset, like the ones that In the crash, the 29 crash, when the stock market crash, they were jumping off the building because everything went up and they couldn't handle it. You didn't hear that?
Well, what we're saying was that Asher Yachsar Loi, Afilu Sus Lirkervolo, Bevet Loot Safano, even as a horse to ride. To ride on the horse, and there's a servant to run in front of the horse. His deficiency, you have to provide the community, has to help people that are poor, whatever they need. All the things that are needed for every person. But after that, he's adding, Acher the Meisiv, Asher Yachsol, the Pasuk says, the deficiencies that he is lacking. Shetzirch l'sabr gam ma Asher Yachsol lo yisuslir kovol oved lo tzofon. You have to provide to him the amenities and different things that he had previously. Even if it's a horse and a servant.
So you got a guys that you are driving around with a limousine, and they got a driver, and
Yeah. And he says, why do you have to do that? He says, what? Why do you have to do it? Because that's what Rambam in the laws of Matan Sanim explains, that this what he was accustomed to. Ashirus, wealth is ribu shefa, is abundance of flow, abundance of wealth. It's not. He said Asher yechsar loy, that he will, that he is deficient, is referencing to someone that had more than usual. And now he has some kind of deficiency in him because of not getting exactly what he was accustomed. But he said that true Ashirus is tremendous of Shefa. There's no Yechsa. There's no such a thing as lacking. Voy, the Rebbe Rashab explains in the Maimer, the Shloish and Yonim Eilish, Shnei Yonim Shemilach Yisor. Ashirus, two levels of Milui Chisor and Ashirus. The one level is giving you what you need. Second one is giving you what you are accustomed to. And then there's Ashirus, abundance of everything. Yeshnom Gan Lamala. This exists also in Elikus and Godliness. Chaydua Shekolin Shlemata Mishtashem Yon Lamayla. We know that everything that is happening down here, it's trickling from above. It's ultimately mishtalshel. It's coming down from above. So if we have two levels. First, you have to give him what he needs. Right? The pasuk says day machsoiroi, and asher yachsoiroi, and then to his personal deficiency. And then there's also Ashirus. So there are three levels that we're really discussing. And Rabbi Rashab says that all of that exists in Elikus, in godliness. Ve'yenu b'giluyim shel ma'ala shosh madregos b'cholos ma'ala kolam yisev kolam v'atzmus yisev shel ma'ala ma'ala kolam yisev kolam. Says in the levels that are revealing, the Giluim, as Memale, Soiviv, and Ein Sof. Three levels. And Soiviv is above Memale, and Ein Sof is above Memale and Soiviv. Memale kolam neiro mislavish boi lomis vanivoyim lachi seiso. Memal is the light that is enclosed in created beings to give them life. The fear come according to their capacity. Chamaya, we see Nuzal, man, nefesh, mal, saguf, kacha, kodesh, baruch, mal, selom. It's just as the neshama fills the body, nefesh, mal, saguf, Hashem is filling the world. That's the memale kolalmen, the light of memale. Godly energy that it encloses itself in the world, vesting itself in the world. The life that the nefesh, the soul, is diffusing in the body is according to the limbs of your body. Meaning each limb has its own functionality, and the chayus is designed to come according to that functionality. Meaning, your nefesh provides energy of sight, of vision, and also energy in your hands. It comes from the same source, but it's a different type of energy. The energy that goes to your eyes and the energy that goes to your ears is two different energies.
Right.
And that's why one is not capable to do what the other is doing. Your eyes are not capable of hearing, and your ears are not capable of seeing. Right?
But if you lose one or the other, your other will be more heightened, the sense.
And because of the intense use of it. You're more using it more attuned to that specific.
A blind person is very.
He has to make sure he hears, listens to everything.
Helen Keller, I don't know if you ever heard Helen Keller.
Yeah, I heard about her.
She said the worst thing is to lose your hearing. She didn't have.
No, she said. She said the worst. Worst thing than being blind, worst thing of being blind is to be able to see but not have a vision.
Yeah, that's also true. Well, I think we're a lot like that, unfortunately.
It's a lot of people, it says everyone dies but not everyone lives.
Right.
So that's the same idea, you know. It's right. Like living without a vision.
Right.
So that's when Malach Olamim. Chol Evo, Achayus Elefi Erko, every limb has Chayus according to his capability, according to his design. Then you have Sev Kolamin. Sev Kolamin Ayu Shalabala Mislav Shus Bailam. The light that is above enclosement in the world. Shaloch and Usevim. That's why it's an encompassing light. Makif and Soilom is Beshova and encircles the worlds equally. Aval Shayach Loilomus. But nevertheless, Sev Kolamin is above the world but has connection with the world. Shayach Loilomus. It has Shaychus to the world. Has some kind of connections with the world. Valderech, that's why it's a Sev Kol Almin, the worlds. Valderech Chayus HaNefesh Atzmo is like the Chayus of the soul itself. Masha Nefeshi Chay Be'etzem, Agam Shila Maila Beina Roich, Machas and Fashism Labish Baguf. The Nefesh by itself is Chay, is alive.
Right, it's alive
before it encloses in the body.
And after
it. And Beina Roich, it's Chayus is a. Is above and beyond any type of chayus that goes into the body. Mikol mokim ukmo moko. It's like a source. Shememenu nimshech zachayus shabesh amispashem utlavesh baguf. That's where the vitality comes from. Ultimately, is disseminated and it's enclosed in the body. Uvechina zonigas shem chayo ilomim. This level of the nefesh itself, the chayus of the nefesh itself possesses, is called chay olam. The achiluk ben chay lechei. What's the difference if you say chay with a patach or chay with a tzeri? Chay olam teves chay dvuk olam ayinu achal shil olam sumalik olalmin. Chay olam teves chay dvuk olam. Chayas chay beetzem sev kolam. You say chay olam. Chay is connected to the Olamim. That's the Malach Olamim. Chay Olamim is the Chay is one word, and Olamim is another. They're not Vuka, they're not connected to one another. They're not glued to each other, and therefore, it's referring to Sev Olamim. Shleim ad zeh shegam b'chinas Chay be'etzem nikras Chay Olamim. Sev Kolam is also called Chay Olamim, the life of the world. It's like a source, but it's not type. Shemenu nimsheches Chayus Olamis. It's a source that Chayus Olamis is coming. It's like the nefesh by itself. Meisif av mamaimo the v'chinas Sev Kolam. The Rebbe Rashab explains mamaimo the what is Sev Kolam. Nikas gam shem Chay Achaim. There's another name for Sev Kolam. It's called Chay Achaim, the life of all life. The Chayim u'achas and pashetes u'mitlabesh be'olamis. Chaim is the life that is disseminating and enclosed in the world, Mimala Kolamin, Bechina Sevev Kolamin, Shemen Mishael's Chayu Salom is Nikas Chaya Chayim. Sevev Kolamin that is the source for Mimala. The source of energy, the source of life that gives life to the level that is enclosed in the world, to Memale Kol Amin, is called Chaye Chaim. Zo Shomo B'Seinu Zal, Mechaye Chaim Eaten Lecho Chaim. That's the Gemara in Yoimo 71. The Gemara says over there is that the rabbis, when they would say goodbye to each other, they would say, Mechaye Chaim Eaten Lecho Chaim. The one, the source of life, will give you life. Mechaye Chaim. That's what the Rebbe Hashem tells us. Chaye Chaim is a reference to Sevev Kol Amin. Give you long life and good life. Mechaye Chaim, the source of all life, Sevev Kol Amin, Wa'amokir Shemisham Nimshochim Chaim. That's the source where the life is coming from and descending into this world. So far, we learned the superiority of Asher over Ani, being Asher.